once you sit on the bike, you won't feel that weight at all. It's so nimble, and yeah, I'll show you all about it. Anyways, I'm gonna live with this bike for some time now. I don't know how long, but
hey guys, I think you all know me. My name is Deepak, but they call me DV. That's mainly because of my YouTube channel. I'll give you my ride history or experience. I've had a couple of bikes before. I'm actually a super sports guy. Used to a lot of super sports machines like RC390, Daytona 675R, which I had previously. But now I thought I'll move to a naked for some time because of the comfort. I say comfort, I don't want to compromise on performance either. I thought I'll buy a powerful naked, and I luckily got a chance to get this Z1000. So this is a limited bike. Mostly you wouldn't see this bike a lot because it's way too expensive. It's costlier than a ZX10R, mainly because it's completely imported. I think it's a CBU. They don't split the parts and assemble here. They just get the bike completely built up. So that's the reason it will cost you about 19 point change on road. I think it's even costlier now. I don't know if they have discontinued it, but this one is a 2015 model actually, and I bought it used actually. This is a complete stock bike. I love when a bike is complete stock because there won't be any hassle of checking for additional mods. I don't know what the bike would have gone through, right? If you just change the exhaust, then you'll have to tune the ECU again. It's a chain reaction. So better. It's always good if you get a stock bike, and I got one. So like I said, zero mods on this bike. Only thing is it has frame sliders. Actually, this bike doesn't need frame sliders because there are no frames. So this frame slider is from RNG again. It's always better to go for a branded good company frame sliders because they would have done a lot of R&D on the company backend. If you ask me about my experience on the Z1000, I've experienced a lot of bikes before. But specific to Z1000, I think this bike, the suspension setup is very hard on this bike. So the damping is not that smooth. So you feel like you're sitting on a bench or a rock or something. So this bike is mainly suited for highway riding, highway cruising. That's the best usage you can have from this bike. Because even in the sixth gear, it can pull from as low as 20-30. So that's the speciality. Once you hit the roads, you put it to 6th gear, you don't need to change the gears at all. You can just stick to 6th or 5th gear and keep cruising right from 20-30s to 200s, 250s. So I think the top speed of this bike is about 255 to 260, 270, somewhere in that range. I have not done the top speed yet. And coming to the handling, if you didn't know, this bike weighs about 238 to 240 kilos wet. So that's a heavy bike actually. But you won't feel that weight while you're riding. So it's so nimble to ride, especially if you're going alone. Even if you take a pillion, it's too comfortable for the rider and the pillion as well. And the braking, the bite is too good on this bike, especially the front brakes. The rear brake, as usual on any bike, the rear brake bite would not be so good compared to the front. Due to the bike's weight, so you feel the bike is very stable on the highways. And because of the suspension setup, which is very stiff, you'll feel totally confident when you're riding this bike, no matter what speed you're in. And the speciality of owning bikes like this is that it's very exotic, guys. Not too many people will have it because of its cost factor. So people, when they see this bike, they want to just stand for a moment and check it out. So that's the kind of attention you get whenever you're riding bikes like this. So that's one premium feel you will have as long as you own bikes like this.
So enough talking, let me just turn the dash on. Okay, there are no mirrors. I didn't get the mirrors when I bought the bike because Z1000's mirrors are very delicate. That's what I heard from people. So it's already broken. I'll see what I can do for that. I think I'll put some bar end mirrors. So that's about it, guys. What do you think? Z1000. I think we'll have some crazy times, fun times with this bike because I don't have to worry about wrist pain, neck pain, back pain,
leg
pain.
Tell you something about my Z1000. I'm still experiencing it. It's been like 2-3 weeks now since I bought the bike.
So until then, you guys take care. DB signing off. Peace.